really had to have good credit and frequent flyer miles to be able to get over to the West Coast and get on a PGR. I will never stop saying that because that's just how it was in the last game. And I love the West Coast. I was able to finally go out there myself beginning of the season. But now we got players like Lingling and Blitzuigi who have a chance to get themselves on the PGR.
Absolutely. I mean, New England's coming out and we're up there. You know, so yeah. East Coast, it's been nice West Coast, but moving in here, we got
moving in here and we got nobody moving right now. We got two people staring each other down. I feel like Blitzuigi's trying to find his opening date line, like, hey, how you doing? And Ling is just having absolutely nothing to do with it. What's up, Daisy? How you doing?
Yeah, you definitely know, too. One of the things with Blitzuigi is that I think this is one of his first times on Winterside Top 8, so he's definitely going to be playing a little bit more cautious here. Mm-hmm. I'm hoping to see some of that aggressive gameplay, though. That's why he plays his best.
And you know what? But actually, as in a nutshell, Ling may have many zero-to-death clips. He may have many excellent combos. He's really defensive.
He
is super passive, and it makes people really frustrated because that makes him find the openings he's looking for. Hmm. He's a big fan of The Art of War, and in The Art of War, like, he always talks about that book, but in good reason. Don't approach those who, like, can come to you when you're at advantage. Hmm. Basically, is the nutshell of what he tries to, describe out of that.
Oh,
and it works for him.
Yeah, and consider that, too. I mean, when you're in a region full of rushdown characters and players, I mean, when you consider that you have one person forcing you to take a little bit of time, you know, he mixes it up a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
It's good that we get a little bit of both sides, but right now, what's Luigi doing? Actually, a really good job doing this, even with Ling. Seeing him take his space right now, getting pressured by, you know, the up airs there.
Yeah, and also thank you to Sour Luke for following the stream. We appreciate you. And you see that Ling is just trying to follow Blitz all the way off stage. Blitz had a relatively decent percent lead, but if you can't close out the stocks, it doesn't matter. One of his main toolkits he's going to look to kill with is that saw blade to B-reverse back air. On the floats. He wants to catch Ling off guard, but Ling's just remaining grounded.
Oh, yeah. And
you can't really do it now, though. That shield is almost gone.
And if you notice, too, Blitzuigi's doing a really amazing job just spacing himself out. Every single time Ling comes forward, he's trying to punish the shield. He's trying to land the fares. Blitzuigi just a little bit out of the way. Look at this. Look at that movement. Ling doesn't know what to do.
Yeah, Ling couldn't follow the track there, but he's going to finally find his mark, getting that back in to close that sock out. And Blitzuigi almost answering immediately afterwards.
Oh, not going to hit just yet. Right now, getting the back air to secure the first stock. Things are tied right here. Blitzuigi.
Yeah, just putting clean. He's putting in just so much pressure by putting out so many aerials on his way up and down along the side that Ling had to respect every one of them. Problem was, eventually, the defense could get cracked.
Hmm.
Where he's going here, just get simple clean damage. Last hit of there, trying to call out a jump there with the side B.
One of the things you can appreciate here, too, as you watch the set continue, Ling's kind of understanding a little bit about how Luigi is trying to navigate around the stage. And you can see now he's getting a little bit better at predicting, hey, you're going to land on platform.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, you're going to be right here for my fair. Yeah.
That's a key factor as a player, too. And Blitzuigi also pre-predicting that he's going to land right in front of him right there. Ling has been using the side B to try and zone break.
Like, oh, yeah. We're watching 4D chess here. Like, they're predicting each other.
Exactly. Like, there's no reason to try and go in on a Mega Man when they're zoning you out unless you know that you have a perfect opening. It's like, you know what? Daisy Bomber is definitely that opening for me right now until Blitzuigi starts to adjust to it. But it worked for him right there.
Right now, doing a really good job. That back air going to give him a little bit of advantage here, putting the pressure on Ling. Can he recover to the stage?
Yeah, he can. And Blitz is consistent. Ooh, just barely missing. What?
He's utilizing the F-Smash really intelligently, if you notice that.
Yep,
especially after the saw blade.
And you saw how the F-Smash was almost just a bait because he knew that it wouldn't work. But Ling knew that one would work. The F-Smash would work. But he threw it out so he can get him to try and get up and catch him with that saw blade. Ling just saw through it all.
His shield pressure is absolutely impressive. If you look at this, he is not giving Ling any time to breathe. I mean, look at that, right metal blade into F smash, into, like, look at this.
There it is, exact same, the exact same thing as last time, but that time he adjusted. He's like, you know what? You went for the Beach Bomber to get by me last time, right? I threw out that forward smash, I threw out the saw blade, but this time I know where you're going to go and closing it out with that up smash. Small things like that are what catch people off guard and what allow you to close the stocks out.
Luigi's playing out of his mind tonight. I am so proud of this man. Look at this.
I'm very, very impressed. There's not many people in this region who could say that they're going toe-to-toe with Ling pretty much at any point, but look at the way he's just holding this match, even when he's behind. he doesn't look phased at all.
Oh, no. And he's doing a really good job right now. He's playing defensive, but he doesn't hesitate to get a little bit aggressive there. Look at this. He's coaching. He's doing his nares. Leaf Shield doing a really good job for him right there. Look at that shield pressure.
Yeah, and Ling also playing extremely intelligent, too. It's like, no matter what, even though this game has come down to the 1 minute and 50 second mark, he's playing it slow because he knows if he overcommits, you play right into the favor of Mega Man. All you do is just take chip after chip after chip, but now he's taking a lot of damage because Blitzuigi's starting to finally catch on to these Peach Bombers, excuse me, Daisy Bombers consistently. Look, man, he's been playing a lot of Daisy lately for some reason.
Yeah, that's interesting.
It's the same character, but don't say that to them. They
oh, yeah, no, you don't get too much longer for that one. Look at this one, though. He's doing a real... His movement is incredibly tricky right now. Moving around with that Leaf Shield.
And Ling needs to be very careful of landing with these dares on top of Blitz. Because you see how Blitz is just kind of walking towards him? He wants to get one of those parries into up tilt. Like, pretty soon that's going to kill.
Look at that movement. One of the things that I thought was really cool is that, watch this, he baits him in with that Metal Blade, and then he comes in and punishes him with, you know, fair, or gets an F smash. I mean, he's really taking advantage of the fact that Ling is just a projectile gameplay.
And he's also, through via projectile play and slowly racking up some damage.
We're going to see a timeout?
Probably. I mean, unless there's a good straight hitbox in from one of these two, we're at 40 seconds approaching 100 to 108.
Oh, that's fair. Not going to take it just yet. Luigi need to get back on the stage. Leaf Shield not going to do much there.
I see.
Oh!
There we go. And the... in the longest drawn out match we've seen so far tonight, but it's just that type of play you have to deal with when it comes to this matchup. But we got hype over a turnip going all the way down to the bottom stage.
We got American sniper up in here. Look at that. He's throwing that shit. He don't care.
The Puerto Rican sniper.
Puerto Rican. Yeah, you're right.
It's from Puerto Rico.
Okay, you're right.
I can't really roll my R today. I've been stuttering all damn day, man. I think it's because my jaw's hurting from doing quite literally all of the tournament yesterday.
Yeah, no, I saw.
Look, man, I don't really ask for a lot of appreciation and whatnot, but I quite literally did from doubles all the way through.
Yeah, no, you
to the last match yesterday.
Get some nice sleep tonight.
I'm stubborn, and I like casting too much. But going into game number two here, we have Triplast now. And one of the things we saw against Kairos is the extended capability of stalling on the side of the wall by using things like the Crash Bomber so he can hit himself and just make it back. So Ling isn't going to be able to throw down things like turnips at him too much to try and get him off guard.
One of the things we'll probably see a lot of, too, is that I know Blitzuigi has been getting a lot of mileage off of that Leaf Shield, especially with the platforms coming into play here. Maybe give him a little bit more leverage there. One of the things I thought that was interesting there is that right at the beginning, Ling decided to crouch down right over at the slanted corner, making it actually surprisingly hard for Blitzuigi to get any kind of approach.
Yeah, I know a lot of people aren't the biggest fans of slants on these stages, but I like the layout of the stage in general being slightly different from Battlefield. Just enough. And the blast zones are a little smaller, too, so you have a smaller blast on Battlefield with the walls, and it creates new pressure. But look at this pressure from the frame traps from Blitz. Like, he's every time he finds his inch, he's making sure he gets the most out of it.
One of the things that I like, too, is that if you look here, Luigi is doing a great job of conditioning Ling. He'll come down so that Ling is going to come up and try to recover on the platform, and then he'll throw it up here. Because he's like, yeah, you're going to go that way. Yeah,
exactly. And, wow. Almost up being directly into the spiff of the Toad there.
Just barely going to get hit by the ending portion of down smash there. Not going to get hit a second time, though.
And you see what happened with Blitz a second ago? He got hit by the turnip, yeah, but he already had a Crash Bomber in place. So even though he air dodged back down, he was trying to force himself into position to be able to get hit by the Crash Bomber so he can reset his recovery.
That was an interesting exchange there, accidentally giving the Crash Bomber right onto himself, but Ling going to take out that first stock with the bear. Did that shield poke?
I don't know if it shield poked more so than I think that Blitz was trying to jump out so he could eventually find his way to get that up tilt.
See, I like how he does the Smash 4 Sonic thing in which he comes up and he immediately throws his up special.
Hey, you know what? That's a great way to stall out invincibility, because we all know Ling loves to attack from the Angel platform. I have seen so many stocks lost from drop down fair. I never realized that Daisy, while holding shield, literally puts her hands up to her face and like just kind of gets squeamish and scared. That was adorable. Oh, but yeah. what he wanted was a little bit too late. Yeah,
and so that it would blow up. And I mean, smart stuff from Luigi. Unfortunately, the timing was just a little bit off here. No, you know, down, not out.
Yeah, and Winner 70s, this is only a best of three. Compliments of a certain Intero Bank. And he has to play perfectly. He can't go for hard knuckle like Cell to try and snipe an early stock, but Ling with his float, he's just gonna try and time around it and delay him.
I really like what he does at the end there, too. Really does a good job utilizing the what's the end of his up special there to drop down with Bleach Shield. Mm-hmm. I'm going to get a hits off that.
Exactly. Just so he can like have a safe landing, because not many characters have really good safe landing options. Like,
yeah.
It's not an easy thing to do. But when you have Leaf Shield covering you completely, where's he going with Bell? Ling trying to read a jump, but he's going to get punished for it.
Oh my god, Ling doing a really good job being a bit cautious offstage here. You got to be careful when you got Mega Man fishing for that dare.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, the immediate second, Luigi doing an awesome job just trying to take back that one stock that he lost, unfortunately. Ling playing a little bit more cautiously than we typically see as well.
Oh, that was some great bait right there. Ling, too, he just floating in and out on top of Blitz. And if he made the wrong call, there you go. Finally catch him with Peace Bomber. Not the option he was thinking was coming, but he's going to make it back.
I like this foresight from Luigi. I mean, the Flame Slash isn't going to, or Flame Slash isn't connecting there, but look at that. He's immediately like, no, you're going to be up there.
Casey Blitz was looking for a hopeful kill confirm out of
it. See it? Not yet.
Okay, he didn't catch the other up air he was looking for that would have ended Link's stock. But right now, he just can't end Link's stock, period.
Oh. Look at that parry covering it in, getting stage control. Is going to be able to pick up that stock from...
out of position. He was hunting for it, but now he's going to take a golf club instead.
Ooh, I like the use of the leaf shield there. So.
There's a jump free. Yeah, calling it out. Great run from Blitzuigi, but not over just yet. He may have lost the winner semis, but going down into loser's quarters now on top eight.